Hello everybody, it's UXW Bill here again with another repair video. And what I'm going to tell you about today is Bizzarefurhead's laptop, which is sitting here in the pile of a bunch of computers that are all hooked to one KVM switch for various and sundry purposes. Anyway, this is Bizzarefurhead's Lenovo 3100 series system. It's a nice laptop by most accounts, but it's had a little bit of a problem over here at the power plug. What we've got here is a case of excessive strain taking its toll on this power connector. Now, at first I didn't know if this power brick was actually still any good, but it turned out that with a little bit of help from a jumper wire that you can just kind of barely see there, I was able to connect the torn conductor, the neutral conductor, the return, back to the cable inside here, back to the conductor inside here, and to the conductor inside there. And while that wasn't great for a high current application such as a laptop, it did at least allow us to ascertain that the laptop itself, which badly needs to have its screen cleaned, the laptop and its power supply were both undamaged. So I set into figuring out how I would fix this. Now, a new power supply is probably not prohibitively expensive, probably about 40 bucks if a person had to buy one new. But I figured since this one seems to be healthy, why don't we just have a shot at repairing it? I'm sure I could come up with something reliable enough to do the job, and I think I can. Oh well, too many projects, not enough workbench. Guess I'll have to move some of this crap. Alrighty, so now with all that crap cleared off the workbench, here's what we've got. We've got this thing with its broken outer sheath conductor for the ground. That's what I was jumpering across with the little piece of twist tie metal, which, you know, is good enough for a test, but obviously with the current drawn by this thing and the current that it puts out, I think this thing puts out 20 volts at 3 1/4 amps, and that's just a little much for a piece of wire as thin as a twist tie, which is what we found out. But it didn't really matter. It let us know that this thing was working. Well, what I intend to do is cut down into this sheathing here to expose the ground braid, cut a piece of wire off of this dead PC power supply, and then trim into this and find that sheath inside here. I can just kind of see it, but I've got to trim some of that plastic off to find it. Anyway, then when I've got everything all fixed up again and all reconnected, which I'll be soldering to do, so if you're planning to do something similar, have your soldering iron warming up in the background. After I do all that, I'll put some heat shrink tubing around this, and that should buy us a lot of time worth of operation out of this power adapter. Maybe as long as we care to keep the laptop, or maybe we'll have to buy a new power adapter somewhere down the road. But as you already know, there's not too much that I let slip away without at least trying to fix it one way or another. Alright now, I've got my braid exposed at both ends here, and this is pretty crappy thin wire. It's not very nice to work with, but there ought to be enough here to make a good repair. And I've actually cut my piece of power supply wire out, and now I've just got to strip the ends, tin it up, solder this together, and then in the end here, to help protect it and provide rigidity, I'm going to try to put this heat shrink tubing over the end here, if my lighter would quit disappearing. Okay, now, to lend a little stability to this and to try and help it stay together under stress, I've gone ahead and hot glued it here at the place where I soldered the first junction back together. Now I'm ready to do the same for the second, and then when I've got it done, I'll hot glue it back together. For more rigidity, I'll probably just go ahead and hot glue both of these wires side by side to one another, and then it'll be time for the heat shrink tubing. Alright now, with that soldered back together, and that's really not my finest job of soldering, but that was kind of difficult to do, actually. Now it's time to go ahead and hot glue this back together, and then it'll be time for the shrink wrap, and then we'll get the laptop over here and see if it actually works. Now there is the before it's shrunk, heat shrink tubing wrapped around that thing. Now I'm going to go ahead and heat shrink it, and then we'll plug the laptop in and see if the repair is effective. Hey everybody, it's time for the best part of all, and that's the fire. Let's just shrink this up here. Probably could use a little stronger of a flame, but no, it's working. I want to avoid getting the rubber too hot. And that's all there is to it. All right, here it is, the beast up and running. Now, right now, I went ahead and started it up on battery power. Not real big on these glossy screens. They let you see too much of the ugly guy that's running the camera. But here we go. Here's our power adapter. You lean this over, and I think it plugs in right back. Maybe that's the... Yeah, that must be the S-video connector. There it is. Look at that. It is now charging that battery. Yep, got our battery light on there. I don't think this thing's got any more than the battery light. But it's definitely plugged in and charging. So I would say that the fix has been successful. Wouldn't you give it the Bizzarefurhead seal of approval?
Cha-ching!
Alrighty, we'll see you later.